I received some feedback with regards to my recent Banana Islands video that's so thorough, I thought the best way to address it would be to chuck together a response video. You know, now no one's doing them anymore and they've become retro themselves. It mostly concerns the music, and why I didn't use any of it from the actual game. I did plan to, as I made a point of mentioning it in the commentary, but then realised that to isolate it without the overpowering sound effects, I'd need to use an Amiga workbench-based tool like Jack the Ripper, as this game gets so little attention it hasn't already been done. The other issue I had was, because I'm incompetent, I kept dying every few seconds, and that causes the music to cut to another sample, making it difficult to capture a continuous segment. At one point I decided to give it a whirl regardless, although then the tool I used to cut video, AviDMux, wouldn't preview it without garbling the sound, so I couldn't tell what I was listening to anyway. In the end, the ingenious solution I devised was to give up entirely, and just use neatly packaged, vaguely relevant MP3s, in the hope that no one would notice. Only they did. Don't. Later it dawned on me that the game allows you to disable the sound effects so it's possible to capture just the music. That is, providing you can survive a relentless battering from the enemies for long enough. So I played again with the sound effects off, and for a flash in the pan moment actually reached the teddy boss that appears after stage 4. The upshot is that I've now been able to convert it to audio and put together a proper soundtrack comparison video, which if you hadn't already guessed, is what you're watching now. You can put your rocket science certificates away. There are no prizes up for grabs. Sorry.
Right about now. The Funk Soul Brother. Check it out now. The Funk Soul Brother.
As mentioned in the original video, Banana Islands includes a remix of the Rainbow Islands theme tune. Take it away, Charlie. That's what I've christened the starring chimp, in case you were wondering. When not being serenaded by a reinterpretation of Over the Rainbow, we're treated to an easily identifiable rendition of the Red Dwarf theme tune.
Smoke me a kipper. I'll be back for breakfast.
Banana Island's opening title music is a fairly well disguised twist on the rock and roll track featured in Infogrames' top-down puzzler, Jumping Jackson. Bop, 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 bop Interestingly, the orally ransacked game is a ransacker itself. Jumping Jackson's title music is a remix of Jumping Jack Flash by the Rolling Stones. I was born in a crossfire hurricane, and I howl at my mom in the dropping rain. You ready? Well, it's alright now. The fact is the game. Well, it's alright. Jumping Jack Flash is yes, it's gay. Next up, pop pickers, we have an instrumental version of the Inspector Gadget theme tune. Go-go-gadget record spinner. If you're more of a traditionalist, you might prefer bopping along to the popular Christian hymn, Morning Has Broken, first published in 1931 and covered by Cat Stevens in 1971.
Anybody come to give him praise tonight? Anybody come to give him glory? Somebody shout hallelujah! Hallelujah! Glory! Yeah, oh yeah!
Morning has broken like the first morning. Blackbird has spoken like the first bird. Praise for the singing, praise for the morning, praise for the springing, fresh from.
The game's author, Alistair Murray, must have run out of remixes at some point and so opted to plug the gaps with original music, or at least tracks I don't recognise. Feel free to enlighten me. Thank you. In the intro to Kill 'Em All, another one of Alistair's parody projects, he assigns credit for the music to question mark, but thanks. So I get the impression music choices boiled down to whatever was on his hard drive at the time and sounded appropriate. Musical misdemeanors redeemed, I'll bid you adieu, and split. Thanks for watching, and remember kids, keep it nanas. I know, I'm such a smoothie. That's all part of the appeal.
What a guy.